Hey, what's up? This is the extended version of my DIY REY costume from a few years ago. Now there's more detailed explanations in certain key areas, and I've provided links to the free templates in the description, along with all the tools and materials. The company that originally commissioned this video for me a few years ago no longer exists, and they kept all that stuff behind a paywall, so I'm providing it now to you for free, so you can ignore in the video all the times that I talk about the link to the guide below. It's all here for you free now. Enjoy. All right, so I've gathered all my materials. I've got old boots, sweats, shirts, old leather belts, sheets, an old hoodie. This is all stuff that I just found either at a thrift store or online, but I've got links to everything that you can buy online. So I think I'm gonna start with the shirt. All right, so I'm starting with this basic tee, which I bought online for $7. So all I have to do is cut off these sleeves a little bit for a different shape and cut this V-neck out a little different so it has a bit more of a raw edge. I'm gonna do a straight line from the halfway point straight down to the armpit. All right, that's it for the shirt. So pretty basic, so I can set that aside for now. Now I'm gonna move on to all the sashes. Technically it's one long sash that wraps around Ray's body several times, but I think it'll be easier to make it into smaller sections. So I'm gonna start with a plain white sheet. I just happen to have this one. You can find one at a thrift store for $5 or $10, I think. There's also a link to one that I found online. So this is queen size and it's 102 inches by 90 inches, which should be more than enough to make all these pieces. So I'm gonna divide this into 6 different pieces. So they're all gonna be 17 inches wide and then different lengths. So we've got 2 that wrap over the shoulders that are 48 inches each. We've got 2 that hang down that are 36 inches each. We've got this one that wraps around like a U shape. That's gonna be 54 inches. And then finally one that goes around the waist. It'll be around 38 inches or whatever fits you best. All right, so I folded this over a bunch of times so I can make my strips and just cut through a bunch at once. So now I'll just measure out 17 inches along the whole thing. All right, these are my 6 pieces. Now I'll cut the individual lengths. Be sure and label them really well too so you don't lose track. All right, there we go. Those are my 6 pieces. They're all just gonna kind of drape on the costume like this, and I'll just fasten them on with safety pins. You've got the 2 that cross over the front, you got the 2 that hang down on the sides, then that sort of U-shaped one, and you kind of pretend that they're all one long piece, and they all get cinched underneath the waist piece, along with the belts and the safety pins. But first, I'll move on to this hood and collar that she has. She actually has a full hood back here with the little collar. I found this hoodie at the thrift store for $5, and I'm just gonna cut the hood right off of it. So first, let me just cut it off. All right, so now I'm gonna make the collar out of a piece of cardboard and I'll wrap it in some of the extra white fabric. So the cardboard needs to be 2 inches wide by 13 inches long. I'm just gonna curve the cardboard by bending it over the edge of the table like that. Okay, so now I'll just put this on top of the fabric, cut around it, and attach it with hot glue. I just kind of cut it as I went along, made sure it was really snug against the cardboard as it was curved, and I left a little bit of extra at the bottom. So now I will attach the hood right along the base of that and just glue it all the way around the bottom edge. As I'm gluing this on, I'm just making sure it goes from one end to the other end, so actually I'm just kind of folding it up a little bit to get the size right. All right, so that is my collar with attached hood. All right, looking pretty good. I think the best way to attach this to the shirt itself will be to use safety pins on either end when the shirt's already put on. So now moving on to the pants, and I'm going to start with a pair of white sweatpants. Usually I find these at the thrift store for a couple bucks, but this time I bought these online for $20. These basically just look like sweats that cut off right below the knee. So I'll cut them off there and then use the extra fabric to make these little knee pads. The most important thing is just cutting these off right below the knee. So first I'll just cut that right off. I'm gonna fold this cut inside just a little bit and then hot glue it just to create a nice little hem. All right, so now that these hems are done, I'm gonna use the extra fabric to make these little knee pads. So I'll cut off the elastic and then open these up, and then I'll trace the shape on here using the template that you can download and cut the shape out of the fabric. Okay, so I have these cut out, and you'll notice that there's these little kind of extra tabs on all of the edges, so I'm just gonna fold those over and put a little line of hot glue just to make like a little hem to make it look a little bit thicker. All right, those edges look pretty good. So by the way, if you have a sewing machine, you can totally sew this. I just don't have one, so I don't wanna do it by hand. So I'm gonna cheat by making little stitches all the way around using a small Sharpie. So I'll just draw little dashes around where I want the stitching to go. Okay, my fake stitching is done, so I'll attach these right here to the knees, flush with the bottom using the hot glue. Okay, so those are glued on. I just noticed that she has these little slits on both sides of the pants, so I'm just gonna cut those with the scissors. They're about 2 inches long. All right, that's it for the pants. So I'm gonna move on to the belts and the straps. So I found 3 belts at the thrift store for about $14. You can also just buy these different sizes online. I got a few different widths, 1.5 inch, 1 inch, and 1/2 inch. So first thing I'm gonna do is just spray paint these brown with some flat brown spray paint. This costs around $5, but first I'll mask off these buckles. All right, so I'm gonna save this thin one for later. Right now I'll focus on the thickest one, and that's the one that goes all the way around like this. And then the next thickest one is gonna kind of drape down to the side like this. It's gonna have the holster attached to it. So we're gonna attach these. Okay, so I just marked both places where it's gonna loop around and attach. You want it to just hang down slightly. So I'm just gonna use hot glue for this. And before I glue it, I'm gonna use a little bit of sandpaper just to rough this up and make sure it sticks really well. All right, I'm gonna put some heavy duty tape on the insides of these two just to make sure they really hold into place. I'm using Gorilla tape, but any tape will work. All right, so there we go. So now I've got this double belt kind of thing. Hanging off of the second belt is the holster. So I'm gonna make that entirely from scratch using craft foam. This is thin craft foam. You can get it at a craft store for 99 cents a piece. And then I've got a template that you can download that has the exact shape. It's just one piece. So I've already cut mine out, and I'm gonna trace that onto the craft foam. I always use a ballpoint pen on craft foam. This is a little bit too big for the craft foam, but that's okay. Once I cut this out, I'll just add that extra piece on. So now I'll just add on one of the extra pieces to the end here and finish tracing it and cutting it. Okay, so now I'm gonna spray paint both sides of this with the same brown. All right, nice and dry. So when this goes on the belts, it'll be folded. So the two sides come in, this little bottom piece flips up, and then the top piece flips back over the belt. So let's take that small belt that we set aside, and we're gonna cut 2 slits for this in the back so that this can slip right through it. All right, so I'm just gonna fold these 2 flaps over, then I'll just use some hot glue to attach these right in the middle. And then I'll glue this bottom flap right over both of them. Okay, now there are 2 snaps on top of here, so to fake those, I'm gonna use 2 little googly eyes. You can get a 22 pack of these for 99 cents. These are 12 millimeters. And I'm just gonna hit these with a little bit of gold spray paint. All right, I'll just put these on with some hot glue.
This belt is facing the wrong way. Gotta switch that. Flip. There we go.
Okay, so now we'll fold this top fold over the bottom belt, the one that hangs down. All right, there we go. So that slides around so we can find the right position. So I'll put this on, then I'll strap on the small belt that goes on my leg just above my knee because it's a lot longer than it needs to be. So I'll make a mark and cut that shorter. All right, so that's the length that I need. So I'm just gonna cut the end a little bit better, and then I'll put some holes in it using a leather punch. If you don't have one of those, you could just use an X-Acto knife. All right, looks cool. I'll just touch this up with a little more brown spray paint, and then I'll put it back in the holster. All right, so there's a little buckle right where the bottom belt meets the top belt. And so I'll just make that out of a leftover piece of this craft foam. It's a small rectangle. It's about 3 inches wide, and then I'll make it long enough to just wrap all the way around. So it depends on the thickness of your belt. All right, so I'm gonna hit this with some leftover spray paint. This is metallic aged bronze, which is what I happen to use on my Mandalorian helmet, but knew it would be $6. All right, that's dry, so I'll just glue this right on in the right spot and then fold it around and glue it on the back. All right, that's it for the belt and holster. This will just strap right on once the outfit goes on. So I'm gonna move on to the armbands. She's got one on her wrist and one on her upper arm. So I'm gonna make those out of the same thin craft foam as before. So I've got 2 different templates. They're very similar. So print those out, assemble them, and cut those out, and then we'll trace those right on the craft foam. Then I'll cut them all out and put them together. Okay, this foam is all cut out. So now I'm gonna paint these. One side is gonna be the same brown that we had before, but the other side is gonna be a little bit darker. I'm using Satin Espresso. I already had all these paints, but knew this one was $6. All right, so the two different shades of brown are done. So now they just loop around on themselves. Dark side out, the small end goes into this first set of slots. Pull that all the way in until it stops, and then it folds back on itself and goes the other direction. Then it goes through these two slots. And then lastly, it goes through these two slots. All right, so there we go. That's the one for the wrist, and then it's the same for the other one. All right, those look pretty sweet. They actually look like leather. So the last thing for her arms is that she kind of has this gauze wrapped around. That's just regular gauze. This is a self-stick kind that I got for $5. So when it comes time to put the costume on, all you gotta do is wrap this around your arms. So the last item are the boots. Now I got really lucky at the thrift store and I found these rad boots for $7. They're like really close to perfect, got the little loopy thing and everything. So I've got some links to some options online you can buy. The only thing I'm gonna do to these is add this leather cord to the back for the tie. So this pack was $9, so I'm just gonna cut this on and try and glue it and attach it and make it look like these have ties on the back. All right, these look cool. So to attach these to the boots, I'm gonna make a bunch of little tabs, kind of the same width as this one, which is 3/4 inches, out of some craft foam. I have this scrap, it already came in brown, so you can buy a sheet in brown for 99 cents, or you can spray paint some of the white foam. So I'm gonna make 8 of these strips. There's 4 for each boot, and they're 2 inches long, and then they're gonna fold over. And then make 2 more strips that are 3.5 inches each. All right, on each boot, there are 2 of these tabs on either side and then the longer one on the back. So I'm just gonna look at the pictures and kind of eyeball the spacing and then I'll attach these with hot glue. I'm just gluing the ends of these so when they fold over, there's still a space for the leather cord. All right, so all those little tabs look really good. So now all I gotta do is feed the laces in. All right, that's it. Let's see what it looks like when it's all put together. All right, thanks so much for watching. Be sure and follow me on Instagram for more DIY projects. And you can follow Micah on Instagram and TikTok. And you can see the full supply list and guide below. Let us know in the comments what other DIY costumes you want to see.